In this video, we'll look at how to download and install Notepad++ on Windows system. So let's get started. So first we'll download Notepad++. So for that, we open our Chrome browser. So here in the Chrome browser, search for Notepad++. So here in the first search result, you will see the official website of Notepad++. So just click on it. So once you click on this one, so in the next page you will see this the website having all the version of Notepad++. So right now we can see this 7.9.1 as the latest version, but somehow if you want to install any other version like 7.8.8, so just click on it. So once you click on it, you will see the downloaded files for 7.8.8. But in this video, we'll be installing the latest version. So let's go back. And now let's click on 7.9.1. So once you click on this one, you will see this downloaded 32-bit. And you will see the download for 64-bit. So my laptop has a 64-bit. So if you want to check the 32-bit or 62-bit of operating system, so in that case just go to desktop and right click on this PC and just go to properties, and once you go to properties, you will see the system type which is 64-bit operating system. So that way you can check the type of this your system type. And now let's close this. Now here for 64-bit, you have this installer which will download the exe file for Notepad++. Even you can download this portable zip file or 7z file, but we'll be downloading this exe. So just I click on this installer. So once you click on this one, it will start the download. So now my download is completed. So for installation, just double click on it, or you can go to your folder, download folders, and here you will see this exe file. So just double click on it. Let me minimize all this and say yes. And here it select the English as a language and say next, and say I agree. So click on I agree, and here you have to give the path. So by default it takes C, then program files, then Notepad++. So we'll go with this default folder and say next. And here, okay, we'll not change any configuration, we go with the default and say next. And I check this one, which will create the shortcuts on desktop, and say install, which will start the installation for Notepad++. So our installation is completed, and here the run Notepad++ is checked. So we'll start the Notepad++, and I say finish. So here we can see this Notepad++ open. You will see some release not. Now if you click on file, you will see all this new file or open or all other option for the files. So just click on new, which will create the new file for you. So here you have this plugin. So using plugins, you can install the Notepad++ plugin. So for that, just go to this plugins admin. And once you click on this one, in the next window you will see the all list of supported plugins. So now let's install this JSON viewer and say install and say yes. Yes, so which will download this JSON plugins and install. So now let's go to plugins, and here you can see this JSON viewer plugins installed on my Notepad++. Now let's open one of the JSON files. So I go to file and say open. And now go to the desktop, and on desktop I have this example 2 JSON file. So select it and open it. So here you can see my JSON file is not formatted. So what I do, I just select all and go to plugins and go to JSON viewer and just click on format JSON. So which will format my JSON file. So even you can see here these curly bracket. So if you click on this one, it will give me the start and end of this curly bracket. So this is how it comes handy when you use this this Notepad++ with JSON or any JSON or XML or any format of the files. So even if you click on any word, okay, here I click answered, so it will highlight all the word which is available in the text file. And if you say Control F, which will select this answered and will find this one. And if you say file all in all open document, so here in this result you will see all this search result. So here even it gives the line number, so line 12 15 21. So if you click on 21, you can directly go to this line number 21 and you can search for that text. So this is how you can use this search result in your Notepad++. Now let's open the new file. So I say new and I type something, and if I don't save this file and if I close my Notepad++ and reopen it, okay, this unsaved file will be saved and it will be persisted in my Notepad++. So that way you will not lose your unsaved text file. So this is also one of the good feature of Notepad++. And you can also explore some other features of Notepad++. And yeah, that's all for this video. Hope you enjoy this video and you find this video helpful for downloading and installing Notepad++ on your Windows system. And thank you for watching this video, and see you in the next video.